Hart is the man to beat in 88.
If we hold ourselves to those highest standards, then the voters cannot do otherwise.
Senator, I want to ask you some questions about the woman in your townhouse.
Can you tell us how you know her?
You can't be serious. No one is staying in my home. There's no need for that.
I am serious, sir.
It was the fall from grace that crushed Gary Hart's bid for the White House. And now that story's being told on the big screen in the new movie, The Front Runner. And the movie's director, four-time Oscar nominee Jason Reitman, joins us now to talk about it. Good morning to you, Jason.
Good morning. It's a pleasure to be here.
And we should say welcome back to St. Louis. As
many of you
remember, he shot Up in the Air here. Has it been 10 years?
It's almost 10 years. And, you know, I fly into Lambert and I just start seeing the locations from Up in the Air immediately. As I walk through the airport, as I drive past the Airport Hilton, all the way to the Cheshire, where I spent the night last night, it always feels like I'm revisiting that movie. And I think it was kind of my fondest filmmaking experience, making Up in the Air here.
No kidding.
Yeah, no, I really loved it, and I felt like the people of St. Louis actually took a really big part of that movie. If you think about, you know, everyone who was actually fired in that movie by Clooney was someone who had actually lost their job in the recession of 2010, either here in St. Louis or we also saw shot in Detroit. Yeah, I loved the experience of making the movie here.
Well, we're glad you're back.
Thank you.
Back, and you won an award last night. Congratulations.
Thank
from
you very
St.
much.
International
Thank
Film
you.
Festival. Was it the Contemporary Cinema Award?
Yes, that was it. Okay. They were kind not to give me a Lifetime Achievement Award and make me feel really old.
You're too young for that, Jason.
You never know. they eat the old in my business.
That's true. Hey, let's talk about this new movie. It's called The Front Runner, and it's the story of Gary Hart and his sort of fall from grace, as we said. First off, why did you want to tell this story? Like, what hooked you and made you go, I want to make this movie?
Well, I mean, look, first of all, it is a really entertaining thriller. You got a movie about a guy who goes from being the next president of the United States, and less than a week later, he leaves politics forever. Why? What happened? And what is its connectivity with today? And in this movie, we're asking the questions that everyone is asking these days, you know, gender politics. What's the line between a public life and a private life? You know, why do scandals matter?
Well, and this, you know, in the midst of the Me Too movement, there have been certainly a lot of sex scandals in politics these days. Were you making this movie while all of this was going on?
I mean, what's interesting is that we wrote this movie in 2015, and then the presidential election happened, and obviously a lot has changed since then. And when you make a movie, you're making something that is a kind of a moving, living, breathing object that is going to change in the perspective of the audience. But, you know, at the core of it is this movie with 20 main characters, 20 points of view of the journalists, the campaign people, all these people surrounding Gary Hart, played by Hugh Jackman.
Speaking of which, as we all know, Hugh Jackman is an Australian. What made you pick him and think he's the perfect one to play this sort of infamous figure in American politics?
Well, I'm a Canadian, so I suppose we felt that this needed to be kind of an outsider's point of view on the scandal. But look, Hugh Jackman is one of our great movie stars. He is, as an actor, he is as hardworking as they get. He is generous. He's the kind of movie star that, you know, reaches out from the movie screen and grabs you by the ribs as an audience member and yanks you into the film. And in this movie, he does something he's never done before. He plays an enigma, someone we desperately want to understand, and he pulls us right to the edge but never lets us in the door.
Has Gary Hart, the real Gary Hart, seen your movie?
He has. You know, we've shown the movie to everyone involved. We've shown the movie to Donna Rice, showed the movie to Gary Hart, Lee Hart, the family, the campaign people. I think there's an empathy that they feel the movie shows them. And this is a story that has kind of been kind of rounded up as just a joke with the punchline of a name of a boat. But at its heart, this is a moment in which the ground shifted under all of our feet and really put us on the road to today. You know, I'm like anybody else. I look around and go, how the heck did we get here?
Right.
And this is one of those stories that gives you the thread of how we got here.
The movie is fascinating. It's called The Front Runner. It opens here the day before Thanksgiving. Now, we mentioned Up in the Air.
Yeah.
I want to show you a clip because we have brought in one of your movie stars in this studio today. So let's pitch to the clip. And there you see, it's not him. It's him.
Ah.
And here he is. Come on in, Glenn. Glenn Siebold and Jason Reitman.
It's good to see you again. If I remember, it only took you about 26 takes to get it right, if I remember right.
But I was there all day for that two-second spot.
Yeah. Tell people how you got to be in a Jason Reitman film.
Well, they had the all-day event for casting extras. Mm-hmm. I didn't go because I knew it was going to be crazy. Mm-hmm. And then they came back and said they didn't have enough white males. So I was able to send an email.
It's the only time in life when we do, for why do we need more white males?
Exactly.
Thrilled that you were in the film.
Thank you.
It is good to see you again.
It was a great experience. Great bucket list.
Were you happy with how I directed you?
Absolutely. It was great to see it in action and a great appreciation.
Did you like his performance?
Oh, I mean, I'm...
All 2 seconds? I
just watched it on screen, and I was immediately moved and drawn right back into your character.
Yes.
All the research you did paid off.
Yes, thank you.
I think
you.
I saw a tear.
I think so.
Glenn, thank you. Jason, always good to
oh,
see
that's
you,
great.
My man.
Yeah, good to see you. Good to see you again.
Thank you.
The movie's The Front Runner. Hey, we're going to talk more about this in the show after the show coming up. Here.